Hi everyone, this is the last video for React interview questions. I have already covered a lot of questions. Maybe in future I will be publishing more. So how you can make a reusable component in React? So that is most common questions, like it is applicable for the Vue.js, for Angular or for React. So like you need to have a loader functionality for the API call. Until unless you get the data, you wanted to show the loader. So those kind of component you create as a reusable component. You can create your table with the pagination feature as a reusable component. So when you see any library like a React bootstrap library, that library is actually giving you some predefined components. Similarly for your own project, you can create these all different kind of components, table with paginations, or you can create a list component, or you can create a tab component. All these reusable components you can use or you can create from scratch. Those can be reused across your application. Best practice for the set state method, first of all, don't trigger it every time. Trigger it whenever there is a need, because set state is expensive. It is re-rendering your whole component flow if there are multiple children component. So try to see if there is a use case of doing a set state. You will do a set state, it will work, but it's always you need to think about, should I do the set state here because it is going to re-render everything. When should you create a functional component? It's obvious whenever there is no state object and you are used creating a component to just display the data, then you can just create a functional component. So functional component are just can be written in a single line if you don't have a multi-line JSX code, but it is just with arrow functions. You just write a function and return the JSX content, and that functional component accept the props. So you just render the props attribute in the component itself. So no need to write ES6 class for it, because functional component are nothing to do with the state. They get the props data, they display it, and job is done. Okay, so what is the one-way data flow in React? Now I will not be answering these questions because we already know that React provides a one-way data flow from parent to the child. So how to send an event to the parent component? So in the onClick event of the child component, you can write props.handleClick. So when you write any DOM event with the props.event name, it is actually referring to something which exists on the parent component. Okay. So how to inspect the React props and state on the browser? So what you can do is you can install the React dev tool, which is you can do that from the Chrome add-ons, and that will help you to inspect the state and props for individual component. You can inspect the React component fully. Okay, I think that's all. Last question is how to enable the Redux dev tool. So in the store, you need to enable the dev tool extension, and then you need to also install the Redux dev tool from the Chrome add-on, which will help you, which will add all these features. So at the runtime, when you have something in the state object, Redux state, you will be able to inspect it. That's it guys. In the future, I will be posting more videos onto the same, like React interview questions, Node, or preferably JavaScript interview questions in depth.